right here at the USC campus in front of the Annenberg School for Communication building, where I was invited to talk to the students about my experiences as a sports writer.
You're welcome.
I know it's a long
day. The article was great. Good job, man.
More of that. What do you have to say to your...
For the past 4 years, Erikk Aldridge has been teaching a sports PR class at the University of Southern California, one of the best institutions in the nation.
You know, I enjoy teaching the class. It's my fourth year teaching it. I keep coming back because I see people that are interested in this field and interested in learning.
Erikk has plenty of hands-on experience in the field. He was even a member of the Lakers PR department and won a championship with them.
You won a championship with the Lakers? You got a championship ring? Right. Do you have it on you?
I don't have it. I don't have it. It's hard to work. It's so big, you know.
As part of the course, Erikk brings in working professionals to talk to his students. I was there to share my experiences as a sports blogger. The reason the industry is going through a major change. Bloggers have now become a big part of those covering sports, whether you work for a major news outlet or just blog for your own website. I wanted to give the students a sense of what I do, so I showed them some of my clips.
Hey Kobe, how'd you get so big, man?
What's up?
How'd you get so strong?
Man, just working out, man. Just working hard, man. Doing what I do best.
That's it?
That's it, man. I know how you get big, though.
How?
The push-ups, man.
How many?
Push-ups working for you, buddy.
I'm getting shorter. All my push-ups getting shorter.
60, 61, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70. Come on now. Hey, you gotta suck it up.
Need a break? Yeah, suck it up.
71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77. Come on, 78, 79. How's everything going, man?
Life is good.
Good to see you, baby.
How's the family?
Hey, you know what? You gotta know better than this. I'm surprised you can hold the camera right now.
Me too.
Your arms are getting bigger.
Oh, man.
How's all right, dog. How's it going, man? How you doing?
My chair's feeling soft.
Well, let me see it. Nice switch, dog. Let me see it, switch, dog.
At 192.
Get him to it. Up it up.
That's too hard. You got 200 more next on me.
You all right, Kobe?
Oh, you all right.
I'll never bet you again, I promise. I got your money.
Still that.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead and prove it. Take it to the next level. All right, everybody. Thank you very much. It was great. I appreciate it.
How did it go today?
Went very well. Very interesting. Definitely different angle from PR that you usually don't hear in a daily sort of setting, especially the whole video angle and how you saw earlier that, you know, the internet is what's really going to lead to the future of news. So you were able to sort of pick that up earlier. And it's interesting. I thought one of the most interesting things you said was how, you know, there's 50 writers for the LA Times and they only have 300 videos online, but you've got almost 500. And that's because you've got to go out there and you've got to take a, especially with these NBA guys, like you said, they hear the same thing over and over again. So if you can get an interesting angle to get them more interested, they're going to give you more than they're usually used to giving, you know, because they probably get as bored as everyone else hearing the same questions over and over.
Close up.
Okay, what are we looking at?
Many love me, few hate me. That is so true. You gotta love it. You got to. If you hate me, you know what, man? Something's screwed up with you. Let me ask you a question. Do you hate me?
No, I
hate you. You gotta love it. I know.
I just like how you approach things from a really unique standpoint. You're not your typical reporter, and you really cover stories that a lot of other people don't cover. And it makes me want to watch, and I'm definitely going to your website.
You just asked me for my hat. Can we see the hat for a second?
Yes. I just love our armed forces, and the Marines right down here in Camp Pendleton, and I don't have anything with them, so I will wear this hat proudly all the time throughout the playoffs. I appreciate it.
What's a bigger shot, that Arnold's governor or that Karl Malone's a Laker?
Carmelo's a Laker.
Went from the guy everybody loved to hate, most hated guy in the world, to the guy that most loved.
I'm just being me, man.
How do you think it went today, though?
I think you did a pretty good job, Ellie. It's definitely different and outside the box, which I think is good because, you know, things are changing and creativity is a big part of the industry now. And you have to be able to create a brand out of yourself. And you won't necessarily always have the backing of the big company as in the past. So I think it's important for people to learn that because they you know, we have a lot of seniors, a lot of graduate students, and I'm sure they've received a lot of instruction about the way things were or, you know, a certain way of doing things. But there's also other ways, and I think that's important to know.
Peace to Hutch. Yeah, yeah. Black Superman. Black Superman. Uh-huh. Everybody knows. Yeah, yeah. Peace to above them all.
When an NBA superstar like Shaquille O'Neal makes derogatory remarks about somebody's mother, it's pretty entertaining. Except...
2 + 2 = 4, that's correct. Yes, that's very correct.
Shaq, do you have a special routine before the playoffs?
Yeah, let your mother rub my feet. Yeah, it's going to be a fun game tomorrow.
Is this going to be a new thing for you to do interviews laying down like that?
Only if your mother's next to me. Ooh. Set yourself up. Oh, I'm sorry, Eli. I'm sorry, Eli.
You're in very good shape these days. What's the secret?
I was with your mother last week. She trained me very well.
Before games, last few games, you're just rebounding like crazy.
Have you seen your mother?
need a pillow?
Hello. Comfortable?
I'll tell your mother to send one.
Shaq, that's a very nice hat.
Your mother gave it to me.
Shaq, Shaq, how do you mentally prepare for the final? Any special routines?
I have lunch with your mother.
Is Shaq always that mean to you? Or
no, he's joking.
I know he's joking, but he's always like, always your mom.
Always. I walked into the locker room the other day and he told me, Ellie, seckbach, shut the hell up before I even talk. So yeah.
That's awesome.
It was really entertaining. I definitely enjoyed it. It was nice to see the lighter side of the players. When, you know, they're not all serious, they're just talking about the game, when they're just, like, joking around.
We're just being themselves.
Exactly.
And what have you learned in the class so far in the last 3 weeks?
Probably focus a lot on new media and how the field is changing.
I assume that we're going to be learning about how to relate to the athletes, what you want to do to make them, you know, look positive if they're maybe not, you know, how to put on the right front that makes them look good to the public at large.
Your students here, they're the next generation of sports PR people. What are they learning?
Well, I think, the bottom line, Ellie, is times are changing. And, you know, they have a first-hand opportunity to hear from the people that are in the business. And that's the most important thing in the class, to get actual experience from listening to people that are in the business that are riding the waves of change. So I think that's the thing that we hope to get out of the class, you know, throughout the semester and have some fun and some great learning experience. We're going to be heading to a Laker game.
Okay.
And so maybe we'll see you there.
Definitely interacting with Shaq and Kobe, such big names. And so, you know, it's fun to see, you know, the lighter side. I know Shaq's probably a big goofball, so you get to see that a lot. It was really fun to watch, yeah.
You agree?
Yeah, I watched your videos.
Oh, thank you. From your experience as a sports PR person, what tips would you have for someone aspiring sports PR person who wants to get into sports?
I think, you know, the main thing is to really have a genuine passion for what you want to do, a vision that you can do it, that this is something that you're very interested in, and not waver on that. Because, you know, it's very competitive and, you know, really the strong will survive in that particular industry. You got to stay the task. You got to really be willing to do the extra work.
From the USC campus in South Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.